Hey, welcome back, everybody. It's the Spaniard here of the Distinguished Huntsman, and welcome to another great episode. Today, we're going to be talking, like I mentioned, about target practice. Now, I don't know if you're like me, but confidence in my world is key. Let's start off by saying this. I've been hunting here since about maybe 2014, 2015, that area. And each year that goes by, I always try to take away my mistakes. You know, what are my takeaways from the mistakes? One of those mistakes was my shot placement, right? Now, I'm a Marine. Now, part of the Marine culture is being able to be a very good marksman, and that's with the rifle. Now, I use a bow. I'm a bow hunter. It's a lot more challenging. You have to be a little bit more disciplined, a little bit more silent, because you're coming up really close on whatever it is you're hunting. So every shot counts. So that's what we're talking about today is practice. Get out there every chance you get and target practice. Well, if you're new to hunting, you're gonna realize that it takes a lot more effort to enjoy this sport, because it is a sport after all, and for some it's a lifestyle. And if you're new to archery, start small. You don't have to go out there and buy the most expensive bow. It's not going to make you shoot better. Get yourself a nice decent bow, go get it inspected. My choice or my advice to you would be is make sure you take it to a specialty, an archery shop where they specialize in tuning up bows and being able to restring them properly, add sights, whatever it is. Don't get frustrated. It can get pretty frustrating when you're trying to improve your skill or improve your craft and, you know, things aren't gonna go your way. It happens, so don't get discouraged. You may lose a couple arrows. You're gonna get bit up by mosquitoes. What do I got right there? What the hell is that? So just be prepared. If you're gonna go out and do some target practice and you're gonna be out in the woods or in a field, make sure you bring some mosquito repellent, because that could definitely put a damper on things. And last but not least, learn to have fun. Sometimes you just gotta slow down and take a look around you, and you know, today's a perfect day to explore something new and master my craft. So again, you may not be a pro at bow hunting or archery or hunting or fishing for whatever you want to do, but you got to take that time for yourself and enjoy it while you can. Get out there and have some fun. Get out there and master your craft. All right, there's nothing more frustrating than getting out to your hunt. You got everything all set up. You did your recon, you did your research, you know exactly what you're going to be hunting for, you got the perfect location, you got your wind right, you got everything is good to go. But yet your heart starts racing because of that buck fever that we all get. And your heart starts racing and you make that shot, and next thing you know, you missed. So I've been there, done that. I've gotten excited. I've gotten that buck fever, and it happens to the best of us. But that's where confidence comes in. That's when you want to get out there and run around, get your heart rate up, just as it would happen during an actual hunt. So what I normally do is I'll run a lap someplace. I'll just run about 100 yards, get my heart rate up, pick up the bow, control my breathing and let it fly, right? So it's all about preparing yourself. Circumstances dictate my tactics. I don't know if you saw that in the intro. Very key phrase. Circumstances will dictate your tactics. So here in this circumstance, get the best out of your practice. Practice makes perfect, right? I talked about the 7 P's before in other shows. So prior proper preparation prevents piss poor performance. Yeah, that's a mouthful. So the more you practice, the more confidence. So practice equals confidence, yes? So get out there, let's get that confidence up. Let's tighten up those shots and let's make those arrows fly straighter than ever. Thanks again for watching. Tune in next time for another episode of the Distinguished Huntsman. This is the Spaniard. Keep it tight. Remember this, the 7 P's,
about the fourth time that a-hole has flown over my house. He's flying so low, the tops of the trees are moving. That was behind the house, so my camera didn't catch it.